Hi, I'm Roseanne Longo, and today I'm in store with TV celebrity chef and cookbook author Emily Richards. And today we're going to be making crab cakes and serving them on a nice bed of greens.
Roseanne, this is a classic restaurant favorite that's full of flavor, but we're going to make it economical by making it at home.
I can't wait. I love seafood, and I'm looking for a new dish to serve friends this weekend.
Well, this is definitely the one.
All right, let's get started. We're back in the kitchen with Emily, and we have all the ingredients to make the crab cakes.
We sure do, and we're starting off with the imitation crab meat, which has lots of flavor and helps reduce the cost when we're making it at home.
Great.
So what you want to do is take that package and just crumble it up. You can go in there with your hands and break it up.
Okay.
And this is really going to help the crab cakes stick together. And then we're going to add some chopped fresh parsley for a nice little bit of herbiness, and some red and yellow pepper. Now, if you don't have both, you could just use all of the same color. And some minced onion and lemon juice. So that's really gonna give us a nice big zing. Wow, you're good at that.
I'm getting good at this.
And then some Old Bay seasoning and tartar sauce. And what gives us that distinct flavor in crab cakes is that Old Bay seasoning. It's just a mixture of spices and salt, and it's used a lot in dishes that are very, you know, seafood oriented.
Okay.
And then to finish it off and help bring it all together, we're using some panko breadcrumbs. And they're great because they offer a really nice texture and they help absorb all the ingredients together. So you can see, really quick and easy, lots of great color and big on flavor for sure. So now that it's all ready to go, we're gonna divide it into four. And this is where you have to get your hands dirty, Roseanne.
Yes.
Your favorite thing, I know.
Why would get my kids to do this?
And you know what, they would have a blast with this because it's all squishy and fun. It'd be like a craft for them. So make sure you squeeze it nice and tight into a ball, and then we're gonna flatten it out just like that, about an inch thick, because we want these to look impressive. If you were going to a restaurant, they'd be just as big and delicious, so you wanna do this at home too. And what's great is you can make them ahead, so just wrap them with plastic wrap and pop them in the fridge, and then they're ready for the skillet. So we're ready to cook up our crab cakes, and I'm just heating up our pan. I'm gonna add a little bit of canola oil here. And that's really gonna give us a nice texture. We're gonna be able to brown the crab cakes and keep that moistness inside.
Okay, now why are you choosing frying them as opposed to baking?
Well, you get that nice golden brown color on the outside, but most important is that they stay moist inside. We've worked to get that nice moisture in there, so we don't wanna lose it, because that's what people love about crab cakes. So they're just gonna take a couple minutes, but we're also gonna be serving them with a great salad.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And we have Western family and balsamic and fig. I can smell the fig.
It's a great combination, nice for sure. Nice and simple, a great way to make a quick meal.
So I'm just gonna give this a quick toss.
Perfect, quick, easy meal. And these just need a couple more minutes and then we'll be ready to turn.
These look fantastic and they were super easy.
And definitely fast and full of flavor.
For this recipe and other great meal ideas, come in store and pick up your Longo's Experience magazine or visit us online at longos.com.